गुड इवनिंग चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू आर सेफ एट होम। सो इट्स अवर फोर्थ सेशन एंड इन अवर प्रीवियस सेशंस वी स्टडीड अबाउट हैबिटेट, अडैप्टेशंस ऑफ फिश, लोटस एंड टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट अडैप्टेशंस ऑफ एम्फीबियंस। सो लेट्स वी स्टार्ट अवर टुडे सेक्शन। ओके, हैव यू हर्ड अबाउट एम्फीबियंस? No? Okay, then I will tell you the animals that living on both land and in water are called amphibians. The animals that living on both land and in water are called amphibians. Now you know about amphibians, then say some examples of amphibians. Yes, frog, tortoise. Very good. Now we are moving on to our topic, adaptation of amphibians. First two points were given in your textbook. What is the first feature? Yes, slimy body. Look here children, here we can see the slimy skin of amphibian. The skin of amphibians produces a mucus coating, mucus meaning slimy substance, that helps it to keep their skin moist, moist meaning wet, and to protect them from bacterial or fungal infection. Once more, what is the specialty of amphibian skin? The skin of that animals produces a mucus coating that helps it to keep their skin moist and to protect them from bacterial or fungal infection. Then, what is the second feature? Yes, oar-like legs. That is, their legs are modified or developed for swimming, and with the help of this oar-like legs, they can swim very easily. Their legs are also modified for walking and hopping on land. Hopping means jump. And in the body of tortoise, we can see the shell that protects them from their enemies. Frogs can breathe both on land and in water. On land, frogs can breathe through their nostrils. Nostrils means nose. And in water, they can breathe through their moist skin. Moist skin means wet skin. In this picture, you can see the nostrils of frog. Tortoise can breathe only on land, but they have the capacity to hold the breath under water, so they can live both on land and in water. So children, that's all about the features or adaptations of amphibians. Now I am going to give you an activity. Find out the organisms which live both on land and in water. You must read all the given features carefully. So children, it's time for winding up today's section. Hope you understood well about amphibians. Let's revise what we studied on today. Yes, we studied about adaptations of amphibians. Thank you.